operate in society, and if that trust deficit is created, businesses need to fill that gap. Businesses need to win that trust, and that is what is one of the major reasons has forced the companies, and I'm using the word forced the companies to adapt and readapt and transform and change their business strategies. And today, the businesses are responding to the challenge by taking initiatives aimed towards the greater public good as part of their CSI initiatives, including providing healthcare, education, among others. There are also greater expectations from big businesses that they should also contribute towards meeting societal needs of local communities in regions where they operate. And we have seen incidents in Nigeria, as well as in Brazil, in Argentina, and in a lot of other countries where there have been a lot of protests by local communities against those companies where they felt, I'm not saying that it happened, but where the local communities felt that the companies are making a profit using their resources, however, are not giving enough back to society, which consequently affected companies' financial bottom line because of disturbances and protests by local communities in those countries. So that is one of the threats, a major threat, which the companies are facing today. Findings from many earlier studies also indicate that those companies which enjoy the trust and credibility of citizens and investors and policymakers have higher stock returns and perform better in terms of profitability, growth, and sales than their peers. Yeah, sure. Now, can the SDGs launched by the UN provide roadmap to the companies, especially to the big global players? Can they provide a sort of a map, a sort of a blueprint on how